हो गया। हाय, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। इन टुडे क्लास आई विल कवर द पेंडिंग करंट अफेयर्स ऑफ द इकोनॉमी ऑफ द मंथ अप्रैल, मई एंड जून। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी कवर द 11 12 टॉपिक्स, आउट ऑफ विच द वन इज द ONDC, ओपन नेटवर्क डिजिटल कॉमर्स एंड सम अदर टॉपिक्स। इन टुडे क्लास ऑल्सो I will try to cover like 12-13 topics and which will completely cover the April to June current affairs. Beyond it, there is no need to go to the any other topics because we are covering those topics subsequently in the another month. Maybe in the July, August, September month, we will cover all the other topics. Okay. As usual, no sound. कार्तिक, नो साउंड। जूम जूम वो बोल रहा है, नो साउंड। स्ट्रीमिंग इज फाइन। ओके ओके ओके। सो इन दिस क्लास वी विल कवर द टॉपिक्स, दीज आर द टॉपिक लिस्ट हियर। नंबर वन इज द ट्राइलेटरल डेवलपमेंट कॉपरेशन, TDC फंड। नेक्स्ट इज द डेवलपमेंट फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड MSME सस्टेनेबल सर्टिफिकेशन स्कीम, जीरो इफेक्ट जीरो डिफेक्ट, एवरीबडी नो दैट। नाउ द सर्टिफिकेशन ऑफ दैट स्कीम थ्रू द ZED स्कीम। देन द नेशनल टाइम रिलीज स्टडी, एंकर इन्वेस्टर्स, नेशनल ओपन एक्सेस रजिस्ट्री, नियो बैंक्स। नियो बैंक्स इज द टाइप ऑफ न्यू बैंक्स ऑल्सो। Hosting Effective Energy Transition Report by the World Economic Forum. Then the National Initiative for the Promotion of Upskilling. It's Nipun program. There are two type of Nipun program. And next, last is the front running. And this is front running is related to the capital market. So we will look into all these topics through the question as well and the content as well. So Trilateral Development Corporation Fund. This is the fund recently launched by the government of India, and the fund is mainly about to counter the China in its developmental perspective. Everybody know about the China debt trap policy. China is funding the some of the country like the Sri Lanka, like the Nepal and the Pakistan, and yes, and then putting them in a debt trap. And so they are taking the some of the part, like the Hambantota port in Sri Lanka, they are taken up. Similarly, they are doing the same strategy in each of the country where they are investing. To counter that part, the India government launched a new fund known as the Trilateral Development Corporation Fund. The main idea behind the fund, to fund the Indo-Pacific region, to fund the Indo-Pacific region, as well as the startup operating that region. So that we can counter the Chinese investment in all other country. Okay. So it is a fund to design involve private sector, state support for investment in the Indo-Pacific region specifically. So specifically the fund is for the Indo-Pacific region, and its aims to use the fund to contribute to global innovation partnership that will globalize Indian startup for the global innovation partnership. And to promote the Indian startup. To promote Indian startup. So there are two targets mainly. One, to counter the China. Another, to invest in the Indo-Pacific region and promote the Indian startup here. So this is the main aims and the objective of this fund, we can say. Then, this is mainly for the countering the China. It may provide an alternative for the Chinese development and the partnership model, we can say. And also the Chinese influence over some of the Indian neighbors, specifically in Nepal, specifically in Pakistan, specifically in Myanmar, as well as in the Sri Lanka also. Because there are some of the strategic position for the India and also the security concern for the India as well. So in this case, they are spending this. Why this fund is now this time? Because United Kingdom, England approached to the China for providing the 5G services as well as the other services in the Chinese-Pakistan economic corridor, which is a national integrity concern for the India. So India started this fund after the यूके ऑफरिंग ऑफ 5G न्यूक्लियर एंड हाई स्पीड रेल टेक्नोलॉजी टू द चाइना इन सीपैक मींस द एरिया इन द पाकिस्तान देयर. सो द इंडिया स्टार्टेड द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दिस फंड एंड द फॉर द फंडिंग इन द स्पेसिफिकली इंडो एंड पैसिफिक रीजन देयर. Yeah, this is why the India only. This is the India. India government will independently invest in the country. No other countries till now. Trilateral means three. One is to counter China. Second is the private party will contribute in. Private party means those who are funding in the India. They will also contribute it. Another for the startups also. So trilateral means each. All the things. That's for the investment. Private sector. Public sector is all the other stakeholder. We can say private, public, and other stakeholder. And but there also are three things. Number one, investment in the Indo-Pacific region. Number two, counter the China. Number three, to support the startup also. So these are the trilateral fund. So there is a question for it also. If we see, this is a China debtor policy where the China is currently investing and also taking the part. Number one, Iran. Chahabar port developed by India, but here in distributed in the same area, it's by the Chinese. Gwadar port in Pakistan by the China. Similarly, in the Sri Lanka, if we see the Hambantota port in the Sri Lanka is also by the China, and here the Vanuatu is also by the Chinese. So this is the China debtor policy where the China is investing in the billions or the millions and also taking the some strategic location from the country, and also this hampering the Indian security concern. Because of the China excessive strategy of intake. Yeah. दोनों में डिफरेंस है. चाइनीज डेप्टर पॉलिसी किसी भी कंट्री को इतना पैसा इन्वेस्ट कर दो कि वो आपको वापस ही नहीं कर पाए. एंड ऑल्सो इट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द लाइक कि आप उनकी टर्म एंड कंडीशन को फॉलो करोगे विदाउट एनी चेंज. इफ दे आर इन्वेस्टिंग टू मच इन द पाकिस्तान तो द पाकिस्तान इज फॉलोइंग देयर टर्म एंड कंडीशन अकॉर्डिंग टू दे वांट टू डेवलप दैट कंट्री और डेवलपिंग देयर प्रोजेक्ट लाइक द सीपीईसी. बट इन द चाइनीज अदर पॉलिसी दे आर टेकिंग द एरिया ऑफ द अदर कंट्री इन द रिंग फेंस पॉलिसी इन सम ऑफ द एरियाज वी कैन से. बट हेयर दे आर मेकिंग देयर स्ट्रेटेजिक लोकेशन. दे आर नॉट सेइंग दिस इज देयर टेरिटरी बट दे आर मेकिंग देयर स्ट्रेटेजिक लोकेशन. हाँ हाँ वी कैन से कि अलग अलग एरिया में इंडिया को फेंस कर रहे हैं. वी ऑल्सो कैन से बट इन द रिंग फेंस पॉलिसी मेनली दे आर शेइंग कि दिस इज देयर टेरिटरी बट इन दैट केस डेप्टर पॉलिसी दे आर टेकिंग द सम ऑफ द पोर्ट्स ऑन फॉर अ लॉन्गर टाइम ऑफ द लीज सो दैट देयर इज अ सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न फॉर द इंडिया एट दैट टाइम. ओके सो देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन ट्राइलेटरल डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन फंड इज रिलेटेड टू USA. Most of you, without if you know, don't know the topic, you will be confused if there is a three country name within it. Like one USA, Japan, and UK fund for the investment in the India. A fund to counter Chinese debtor policy and investment in the Indo-Pacific. This is the answer here. A fund by the Commerce Ministry for startups growth in India, and a fund by IMF, World Bank, and Asia Infrastructure Bank, renewable energy in India. Most of you will mark this one if you don't know the topic. Okay, so we need to know about all these things. Ki exactly fund hai kya? Objective kya hai? This is a one of variety of the chai we discuss in the test. So mainly here we need to know about the aim, objective, what is the mainly focus of it. And in the question, it's not like they will ask the complete statement about the fund. They will give the, this type of the option and it is related to, general it is related to. So this is enough for the prelims perspective only. Then the development financial institution. Today's second topic is development financial institution. These are the institutions like the banks, like in the name we can say development institution. Development institution. They will provide funding. They will provide loans for the development of the infrastructure projects, green label projects, white label projects, renewable energy projects, where the some of the bank are not able to provide the loans to these projects. Okay, like if there is a State Bank of India, State ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, and the, some other government bank, which are not able to provide the funding to the these projects. So here, the role of the DFI comes. specifically for the infrastructure, for the renewable energy as well. So there are the four category there, where the DFI is divided into the different four category. We will discuss the all the four category here. So in the future, the DFI can also be converted into the bank. It's not like the DFI always will be the DFI, Development Financial Institution. There are certain example. Anybody can tell DFI is converted into the bank? IDBI, yes, it's a good example. Another, ICICI. ICICI initially was a development financial institution, and now it's converted to the full-fledged bank. So these institutions are developed according to the sector, specific sector as well, specific developmental institution as well, and for the specific project as well. Like Export-Import Bank, it's a development financial institution for the export and the import. Similarly, for the NABARD, NABARD is also a DFI, National Agriculture Bank, for the promotion of the agriculture as well as the loan for the agriculture. Similarly, the DFI has having the function in the different sectors. They're also having playing a role in the development of the industry in the country, and also providing a loan to the these structure of the infrastructure and the, which are easily not available from the banking sectors. This is the one region. Second region, if the Indian banks is having the high NPA, non-performing assets, so they are not able to give to the loan to for the higher infrastructure or the higher capital institution. So at that time, the DFI roles comes there, and where they provide the loan to the these institutions. And third one, these are backed by the government security. DFI, Development Financial Institution, loans is backed by the government security. So the interest rate is also less in the DFI. If the government security, backed by the government security, the government tried to give the loans at the lower interest rate, so the project can be become the sustainable there. So this is the three one there. They can be private, yes. ICICI Bank is a private one, yes. So the first DFI in India was the Industrial Financial Corporation of India. Industrial Financial Corporation of India was the first DFI in India that was established in the 1948. That was established in the 1948. Ajitendra Pal, bad banks are the different thing. Bad banks are for the bad loans. The NPA already done. They need to take the NPAs from the like a scheduled commercial bank and then resolve it. But DFI is providing the loan for the infrastructure project. So both are the different thing. Brajesh Kumar, like the NBFC. NBFC is not providing a huge amount loan for the infrastructure project, which required a high capital money. But DFI is providing the high capital money there. Okay. So there are some of the example we can see. The IDBI Bank, hai, NABARD, hai, Exim, hai, SIDBI, NHB, IFCL, also the LIC. LIC is also a type of development financial institution. And later these are converted into the banks, ICICI banks. Life insurance company for development of the insurance sector in the country. So they are also a development financial institution. Then there are four category of the DFI. You can write the four category of the DFI. Number one, national development banks. Number one, national development banks, in which the category like the SIDBI, IDBI, ICICI. These are comes under the National Development Banks category, and the new one, IDFC Bank. Then the sector specific financial institution like the Exim Bank for the export and the import, NABARD for the agriculture, and the National Housing Bank for the housing infrastructure development, like the Pradhan Mantri Gramin Awas Yojana, where the NHB is providing their support for the development of the housing in the country at the village level as well as the city level. In the both the level, urban and the rural, it's providing the loan there. Similarly, the investment institution, LIC, GIC, and the UTI. These are the some of the government institutions which are providing for the investment purpose. And then the last one, state level institution like the state finance corporations. It can be different from state to states. So they are providing the loan to the states. So they are four category of the development financial institution. So there can be the option. They will give the name of the institution. Like they will give the name of the ICICI, they will give the name of the LIC, they will give the name of the IDFC Bank, and also the State Financial Corporation. Which of the following are the development financial institution here? Yes, independently it's now working, but merged with the Axis Bank, but performing the same function, now. Okay, so this is the category of the development financial institution in the country. Anybody can tell development financial institution can take the money from the people, deposits? Why? No is right or not? Well, to ye batao. Le sakta hai, nahi confident? Le sakta hai? Online students, can the DFI take the deposits from the people? DFI cannot take the deposits from the public. They are only funded by the government and also backed by the government security, and so they are providing the loan at a lower rate than the banks. So this is a special condition in the DFI. They are not taking for the public deposits. Okay. So there are the, some of the key features. Yes. Why? I'm telling now why. Because if this become a so difference do dono mein hai, DFI or banks mein, that will be gone away. These are specific for providing the investments, and these are the government backed, completely government backed, completely backed by the government security. If they are also involved in the like taking the deposits from the public and also providing the interest, so doing the main core purpose of dissolve ho jata hai. So they will not be the specific financial institution. So there will be no difference between the bank and the DFI. So government is keeping them separate as a DFI. So they can be majorly focused on the government projects, which are the high capital intensive there. We can say that because they are not taking the deposit. So they cannot maintain the SLR, CRR there. Yeah. LIC? LIC insurance sector mein se to we can say that NABARD is also like some of the funding from the other sources. LIC is taking the money of the public life insurance company. You are investing for a longer terms, but there are some of the other criteria. If you can say that ICICI is also taking the money from till now, and the IDBI also converted into a bank and also taking the money from the public. But initially when they are established, like they are the example of the LIC, IDBI, ICICI, the development financial institution initially. But now, as per the new DFI bana rahe hain, so in that case, mein, they will not take in a deposit. But LIC was initially not taking the deposit. But now they're converted into an insurance company. Now they're converted into an insurance company. Initially, it was developed for the developing of the financial sector in the India. Okay. Now it's the criteria is changed for the LIC there. The sector or financial sector. Financial sector, not for the social sector. Social sector ke liye alag hai. Financial sector, specifically for the financial market, for the insurance penetration in the country, we can say. Ke insurance penetration ke liye LIC ka major role hai wahan pe. Pension, insurance, sare financial sectors in the capital market that are controlled by the SIDBI. Jo bhi security information exchange hai, also they are controlling there. Social sector mein wo help karte hain. If you can say ki help, help we also comes under the social sector because they are providing the social security to the people. So in that case, we can say this comes under the social sector. So here the, which? No, no, they are the separate entity. They are not comes under the NBFC. NBFC are the separate entity and the DFI are the separate entity. And the commercial scheduled banks are the separate entity, we can say. So we can say DFI do not accept deposits from the people. So this is the main criteria here. The, if the, any development financial institution which are in investment in the infrastructure, investment in the capital infrastructure, or the major larger projects that are not accepting the deposits from the people. So this is the main criteria for the DFI here. They provide the technical assistance like the project reports, viability study, and the consultancy services. Like if there is any implementation of the express highway, Noida Express Highway, there is a need to be study kis basis pe kitna footfall hai, kitna like kitna time mein kitne like a vehicle is going through the this road. So this old study kitna viable hai. If we are constructing this road, the viability will be kitna rahega. If we are charging the toll charge there, to viability kitne time baad khatam ho jayegi. So that is also, these studies are also provided by the DFI. So they are providing the study, they are providing the rupee and monitoring the project as well. In the, for the credit enhancement for the project, if there is any lack of funding to the any projects, so they are also providing the funding credit enhancement for the projects. Ankit is asking, DFI has a large scale of fund with long-term development purpose. Yes, the a DFI having the large scale of funds with the long-term development purpose. Also strike a balance between the public goods, infrastructures and the private projects also. Okay, so there is a difference between the public project and the private project. This basis pe they are providing the loan to the these projects. So this is about the DFI. So there is a question in the DFI. With reference to the DFI, consider the following statement. Number one, DFI cost of borrowing increase because of the attached government guarantees. NABARD, Exim Bank and the SIDBI are a development financial institution. DFI accept deposits from the people and invest money in the development. So this is wrong. This is wrong. Only B is the answer. Two only.
So one is the
decrease. It will decrease. So yahi cheeze dhyan mein rakhni. Even in the first statement, I told ki they are the backed by the government security. So there will be decrease in the cost of the borrowing. So this should be in the mind. This statement as well as they are not taking deposit from the people. So these are the important for the DFI. Kam rahega. Commercial bank se kam rahega. Tabhi to like there is a relation. If the interest rate is high, project become the less viable because they need to pay the higher interest rate for the any investment in the project. If the interest rate is very low, like a 2%, 1%, then the project can be viable in the longer run. Like if a project is repaying back in after 20 years, like this road, we can say this Pusa road is building, hum isko build kar rahe hain, it's charging the 100 crores. But we are also building a tax collection center there. So it's a target, we can complete the tax within the 30 years if the interest rate is 2%. If the same interest rate is 6%, it will take the 60 years. After the 60 years, the road ki halat kya honge, to everybody know. So these projects are not viable. But in this case, it becomes the viable if the interest rate is very low there.
Government
DFI category. Nahi, dono mein because this providing the funding to the even the private projects as well as the government project also. Private project mein thoda interest rate higher, they will take it up. Yeah. No. It will not help in the crowding out effect because the banking system, jo unke functions are completely different. Here the functions are completely different. And also in the DFI, the private sector are also invited for the investment there. They can also work in the PPP form. Public-private partnership mein DFI as well as the private sector can work there for the infrastructure project. And some of the projects are also in there running hai abhi, currently running. Like the, I can say the example of Express Highway of the Mumbai and Delhi that's constructing. They are going on the PPP projects. So they are also, DFI is also involved there. So there is a no crowding out effect from the DFI. So these are special purpose vehicle we can say that are particularly for the special projects there. Yes. DFI cost of borrowing decreases because of the attached government security. Like ki, there is any 100 crore worth of rupee with the DFI. Theek hai? This all provided by the central government. How? Through their securities or the anything else. Or if DFI is giving any guarantee for the project, that is also backed by the government here. Then in that case, if the money belongs from the central government, guarantee from the central government, so they can give the loan at a very lower interest rate as compared to the commercial banks because they are not incurring any cost like a for functioning cost nahi hai. They are not having the multiple branches there, they are not having the multiple products there, they are just for some projects which they need to be viability ko dekhna hai, unko suggest karna hai, report tayar karna hai, and also providing the fund. Jo project beech mein bhi ruk gaye hain unko bhi project deke funding deke like revive karna hai. So this is the main function. So it's a government backed, government security saath mein hai. Ki government isne bola, to government ne bola. So is tarike se, these are the very lessable cost there. Decrease hoga na yahan pe. So increase thodi hoga. Cost of borrowing decrease hoga na. Like you are taking a loan from the commercial bank, it will cost to the 5%. If you're taking the loan from the DFI, it will cost to 2%. So the cost of borrowing will decrease there. Now, the third one. MSME Sustainable Certification Scheme. Everybody know about the zero effect and the zero defect scheme. What is the meaning of zero effect? Zero defect? Okay. So now they are come with up the zero effect, zero defect certification scheme. Initially about the zero effect and zero defect. Now they will provide the certificate according to the level achieved by the MSME. So they designed the three level, gold, silver, and the bronze. If the any MSME is producing a top level without any defect, without any environmental concern, they will give a certification of gold certification. Yes. Yes, that's also related to decreasing the carbon footprints there. So if the any MSME is producing the quality, very top quality and without any defects and without also having negative impact on the environment, they are provided with the gold category certification. And below that, they will provide it with the silver category certification. And below that, they will provide it with the bronze category certification. And the government of India is also providing the some of the loans, some of the grants to these MSME for running this scheme, zero effect, zero defect scheme. And there can be the like for the medium, small and the micro enterprises, they are the 80%, 50%, the 60% of the grants that are provided by the government of India. So we can say the scheme is extensive for the practice and motivate and incentivize for the GED certification. GED certification means they will notify your products, they will check your products, and they will give you a grading there. Grading will be given, level 1 will be the bronze level, level 2 will be the silver level, level 3 will be the gold level. Like in your UPSC preparation, if you are reading, you are scoring less than 40, less than 30, less than 20, you are on the level 1. If you are scoring in between 50, 60, 70, like you are pacing up, like a silver category, and silver lining is appearing, like we can say silver lining is appearing in your preparation, means you are in performing and pacing up, but you are scoring more than 100, 120, and your concept are crystal clear, and you are know ki how to study and how to select a topic, what can be the ask from the topic, we can say you are reaching the gold standards. So these are the type of preparation, type of the certification that are provided by the MSME, by the government of India. Mohammed Asa, detect proof production certificate. Yes, yes, yes. We can say it's a production certificate without any defects. After taking the ZE plies, the MSME can apply for the certification. If any MSME is enrolled in the zero effect, zero defect scheme, after the production, they can apply for this certification through the government of India. So there is also some of the we can say subsidy is provided by the government of India. Like for the micro enterprises, they are providing the 80% of subsidy. For the small enterprises, they are providing the 60% of the subsidies. And for the medium enterprises, they are providing the 50% of subsidies for the this type of the products. So this is an encouragement for the environment protection as well, for the less removal of the greenhouse gases, less leakage in the water bodies. So it's also protecting the environment and also taking the name of the MSME at the world level. If there is a zero defect products, their export will be increased and the money will come into the India. So this is a idea behind the zero effect, zero defect scheme. Vocal for local, yes. No, we cannot say the input cost will be high. We can say the skill required is the high. How, let's take an example for the mobile phones. Initially, the mobile phone is costing was the 40,000, 50,000 for a very simple phone. Now the same cost come down to the 7,000, 8,000, and the product is far superior there. And the defect rate is also less, and there is a e-waste is also less. So how we can say that if the product is a superior, it will cost you high, it will cost you the like a higher environmental impact, it cannot be said that. Jada skills nahi, like when they increase in the demand in the country, efficiency badh gayi, they employ the worker which are having the higher skills. They know how to save the money from there. They know the higher technology there. Like take an example of UPI. without the UPI, the cost of causing to the RBI is very high due to the physical trade of the currency. For we are going to anywhere, we are giving in the physical money. So RBI need to print more money. And the printing cost for the RBI is in the crores. Okay. Now we are doing through the QR codes. So that cost is drastically reduced by the RBI. Now the coverage is increases. And also the quality of transaction is also increases because we need not to carry the wallet in our pocket every time. We can go and do the transaction. Same in the case, if there is a, like a government is providing a technology there, government is providing like a skilled person there. In that case, the cost may be the static, but the product may be of the higher quality there. This can be the run. But in the, this can be the both the cases. One is the cases I told you, another is the cases if the, they are not following the guideline provided by the government. In that case, the condition will be different there. So they are the components of the scheme which are provided by the governments. Number one components, industry awareness program. Number one, industry awareness program means here the government will provide it some of the like a session, some of the training with the mentors also will be there. And the training programs like the skill development for the employees. Also how we can manufacture a good quality of products there. So that's also provided by the government. Assessment and the certification. After the manufacturing of the product, there will be the assessment. Assessment means there will be the checking of the product. If the product is of the higher quality or the product is of the low quality, that is checked by the government. And after the completing the assessment, there will be a certification process. After if the quality is good, then the government will provide the certification according to the level of the product. Then the level of the product is according to the certification, gold, silver, and the bronze certification is provided to the MSME there. Then hand holdings kitna hai benefits. If any company is following these steps and making the product without defects and the without effects, so there will be benefits and the incentives. Like we looked into it in the case of the micro, small, and the medium enterprises, 80%, 60%, the 50% benefits will be provided, or subsidy will be provided by the central governments. Like in any industry, like if you take this example of this industry, some coaching institutions are saying if you're scoring more than 120 every time in the test, we will refund your feedback. In that case, this is the incentive for the student to read and score the 120 marks in the each and every test. So there is also a condition here. If you are performing very well, producing the high quality cloth, producing without defect cloth, and there is no effect on the environment, so we will give you the 50% of the subsidy there. So this is the, again, the incentivization of the scheme there. Then the PR campaigns, advertising, and the brand promotion for the MSME, for the each category, the government will do the promotions there. And the digital platform. Also, the government is providing a digital platform for the MSME. One of the examples is the ONDC. All the MSME will also be present there on the ONDC for the selling their product on the country. PR specific publicity campaigns hote hain jiske liye wo karte hain. So what are the benefits? We already discussed the benefits. Wastage ko reduce karenge, environmental concerns kam ho jayenge, quality acha hoga, to product ka export bhi increase hoga, skill development increase hoga, to we can produce more with the higher quality. So wastage kam hoga, substantially increased productivity ko karega, environmental consciousness kam hoga, for energy and the natural resources ko, it will protect the natural resources. Okay. So there's a question on the zero effect and the zero defect scheme. Consider the following statements. Zero effect concept is focusing on non-conformance and the zero waste. Second, the zero defect concept is focusing on zero wastage of natural resources. Third, the scheme also accounts for financial resources and IPR in both products and process. Read very carefully, think, aisa ho sakta hai ki nahi ho sakta, then give the answer. Online students, please also try to give the answers of this question. Any other answer? रीजन बिहाइंड द क्वेश्चन जस्ट टू टेल कि कैसे क्वेश्चन फ्रेम हो सकता है कि व्हाट शुड बी योर वे ऑफ थिंकिंग ऑन द टॉपिक, कैसे आपको सोचना चाहिए, कैसे आपको पढ़ना चाहिए. दैट्स द ओनली आइडिया बिहाइंड द फ्रेमिंग दीज क्वेश्चंस. 1 and 3, आंसर इज 3, सी ओनली. तो प्लीज राइट द सम ऑफ द फैक्ट अबाउट द जीरो इफेक्ट एंड जीरो डिफेक्ट्स. नॉन कंफर्मेशन इज रिलेटेड टू द एनवायरमेंट. नॉन कंफर्मेशन एंड द जीरो वेस्ट इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू द एनवायरमेंट, इज रिलेटेड टू द वेस्ट ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स. तो इन द जीरो इफेक्ट द कंप्लीट शुड बी रिलेटेड टू द एनवायरमेंट. तो दिस कंपोनेंट इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू द एनवायरमेंट, कैन बी रिलेटेड टू द प्रोडक्ट एज वेल. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज रॉन्ग हियर. ओके, सो प्लीज राइट 3-4 lines अबाउट द जीरो डिफेक्ट्स, जीरो इफेक्ट्स. Effects completely related to the environment. Defects completely related to the product here.
It is completely related to the product.
हाँ, zero defect related to the product. Whenever I am telling you the objective of the both the defects and the effect, please write the both the objective. Then यहाँ पे जो scheme को design किया गया है ना, that is specifically the scheme is divided into two parts. One is completely zero effects, means the effect of the waste of the industry from the environment. Environment mein kya waste jayega? And the zero defects, what should be the quality of the clothes? Is there any defect in the clothes? Or defects is not meaning ki wo kharab hai, means the poor quality. That comes under the zero defect. So there are two complete different objective. So in the zero effect, that zero wastage is included under the zero defect, not under the zero effect. So you should be like a clear cut hona chahiye ki kya zero effect mein aayega aur kya zero defect mein hai. Kyunki government ne PIB pe completely separate karke inko likha hai. This comes under the zero effects, this comes under the zero defects. To wo isi tarike se statement frame karenge. To wahi pe confusion. Ha. Optimum usage, optimum usage. Okay, so please write. The Ministry about the Ministry of MSME, implemented by the Ministry of MSME. The scheme was launched in 2016. The objective of the scheme. The scheme accounts for productivity. Scheme accounts for productivity, quality, pollution mitigation, energy efficiency, financial status, human resource, and technological depth, including design and intellectual property rights in both product and processes. So third statement, yahi objective hai. The third statement is saying the scheme also account for financial resources and the IPR in both product and processes. So this is the objective of the scheme directly given there. So now write about the zero defect. This was the complete objective of the scheme. Now about the zero defect, point number one in zero defect. Zero defect concept is focusing on the customer. Agar customer ko without any defect product milega, to customer numbers will be increased there. So it will completely focus on the customer. Number two, it is focused on the zero waste also. Zero defect is also focusing on the zero waste. zero waste. Now, come to zero effect. These are 2 points of zero defect. Number one, it's completely focused on the customer, and it also completely focused on the zero waste. Now, zero effect. Zero air pollution. Zero liquid discharge. And zero solid waste. Number two, zero wastage of natural resources. Now write about the ठीक है हो गया. It's also about the Make in India program. To promote the Make in India program. It's one of the objective also, the Make in India program of the this scheme. So whenever there is a question on zero effect, zero defect, it should be clear between the what is the on a defect, what is on the effect. This is comes under the zero effect. This is not the zero defect. Okay. These are the interchange statement. If this is one, this is one. Okay. So let's come to the next topic. Yes. Before going to the topic, let's check kitna aapko pata hai. Time release study. So first attempt the questions, then we will go to the topic. The time release study recently was mentioned in the news. It is related to the average time for clearance of loans from the bank, the average time taken by rovers for releasing a lander on the surface of the planet, the average time taken for cargo clearance process of the international trade, the average time between the research on a vaccine and its market release in a country. अच्छे से पढ़ लो एक बार. Online student, what will be the answer here? Others, online students, Rahul is saying D, Kaveri is D, Arakabra Bhai is A, Brajesh is saying C, Brajesh is also saying A. So there is no two option, only single option should be here. Na? So he is confirming now A. Answer is C here. Okay. So इस तरीके से ही क्वेश्चन आएगा. एग्जैक्टली है क्या और फ्रेमिंग ऑफ क्वेश्चन इस तरीके से होगा ऑप्शंस का कि आप लोग एलिमिनेट नहीं कर पाएंगे. ऑल द ऑप्शन शुड बी फ्रेम अकॉर्डिंग टू द टाइम कि इतना टाइम इसमें लगता है, इतना टाइम इसमें लगता है. और सारे न्यूज में भी है, ये सारे न्यूज में भी है कि लोन देने में कितना टाइम लगेगा ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस परस्पेक्टिव से. एवरेज ऑफ टेकन लाइक इन मून मिशन या चंद्रयान मिशन में हुआ था. देन the international port trade, the complete report is related to the ports. Then the vaccination release in the country. So is tarike se hi aapko exact hai kya wo pata hona bahut zaruri hai. Until and unless to wahan confusion hi hoga yaar, ye bhi ho sakta hai aur ye bhi ho sakta hai. Okay. Humanly IAS banna bhi to possible. वो भी ये है ना कि आप लोग भाग तो रैंडमनेस के पीछे, ये भी करना है वो भी करना है, कि लिमिट लगाना पड़ेगा. उस लिमिट में भी पढ़ा सबने होगा, सबके पास मंथली मैगजीन है, सबने अप्रैल में जून के टॉपिक्स भी पढ़े हैं और उसके बावजूद नेशनल टाइम रिलीज है क्या, वो भी इश्यूज है उसमें भी. तो बात कहाँ पे आ जाती है, लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेस. तो एब्जॉर्ब टाइम के साथ होगा ना. वी आर गिविंग यू 365 डेज दिए जाते हैं इंफॉर्मेशन को एब्जॉर्ब करने के लिए. ओके. फार्मासिस्ट वो भी बनाना पड़ेगा. Okay, let's come to the time release study. It's a mainly study when a cargo come to any port, when the cargo come to any airport, what is the time taken to release for the other destination. Ek baar saman aa gaya, usko port se dusri jagah pe jaane ke liye kitna time lagega, unloading, loading time mila ke, and the every time, it's sometimes it's maybe the 2 days, 3 days, 4 days. Initially before 2010, 2005, we can say it was taking 2 days, 3 days, 7 days. Now the time is reduced, like the 48 hours for the something, and also for the like 4 or 5 hours for the some other products also. So all these things are by the time release study, and it's a standard set by the three organization. So you should also know about these three organizations: WTO, World Trade Organization; second, Trade Facilitation Agreement; and third, World Custom Organization. So time release study standard are set by the these three organization: WTO, TFA, and the WCO. Trade Facilitation Agreement. Trade Facilitation Agreements under which we are. This is the suitable time for the release of a product from a port. Similarly, for the World Custom Organization, World Custom Organization looking at the custom related products or the custom related rules, and the World Trade Organization is all related to the trade worldwide, globalized trades ke liye, there are some rules by the WTO. So these three organizations are setting some standards for the time release study, and the time release study also important for the ease of doing business in a country. If the any country is taken very less time for the shipping the products to the other country, so it's also increasing the increase of doing business in a country. हाँ तो under है लेकिन इसके अंदर they are mentioning some of the rules and the regulation जो overall है और WTO के अंदर only agreements ये वाले agreements नहीं है, there are multiple agreements जो ये agreement है, this is related to the this one. हाँ organization तो mainly दो है, this is the agreement ना, ठीक है. Now come to the national time release study के अंदर क्या क्या cover होता है mainly. It's a custom include the air cargo complexes. Air cargo की means जहाँ से via air we are taking the products, like the via air जो airports पे आएंगे उसको आगे किसी airport पे जाने के लिए और to the another country it must take which how many times, कितना time लगेगा उसको. Then inland container through the sea routes. Inland containers में sea routes के through कितना आएगा. Then integrated check post जो between the country check post है, when like a product is coming from the one country water to the another country water, so they are the integrated check post. So we are checking कि कोई smuggling का items तो नहीं है. So how much time is taken by the country for checking those product and releasing those product to the another country. So this is also included under the national time release study. हाँ 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 दो कंट्री के बीच में नहीं, लाइक मान लो दिस इज द पोर्ट इन मुंबई, दिस इज द अनदर पोर्ट इन कंट्री आल्सो, वी कैन से दिस इज द पोर्ट इन सूरत एज वेल, एंड दिस वी आर टेकिंग द थिंग्स फ्रॉम द पाकिस्तान, ठीक है. सो हियर इफ द पाकिस्तान इज सेंडिंग सम ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट टू अस, सो लाइक इट विल टेक 3-4 days, देन आफ्टर रीचिंग टू द पोर्ट द प्रोडक्ट इज रीच टू द पोर्ट, इंडियन गवर्नमेंट इसका क्लियरेंस देने में कितना टाइम लेगा. तो दिस टाइम पीरियड द टाइम टेकन टू गिवन द क्लियरेंस देयर इट बी व्हेन इट रीच टू द पोर्ट एंड व्हेन इट इज काउंटेड बाय द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट. लाइक कि कोई चीज आ गई, एक हफ्ता हो गया उसे, अभी तक इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ने फाइनलाइज नहीं किया उसको, तो ऐसे हाँ तो बहुत सारे कंसाइनमेंट ऐसे डेट वॉल टेकिंग 15 days 20 days. So, उन कंसाइनमेंट को क्लियर करने में कितना टाइम लग रहा है गवर्नमेंट को, दैट्स कम्स अंडर द टाइम रिलीज, इसको इतना टाइम रिलीज है. नाउ कम टू द सेकंड वन, इफ आई एम अ एक्सपोर्टर हियर, आई वांट टू एक्सपोर्ट समथिंग, आई गो टू द दिस पोर्ट और द सूरत पोर्ट देयर, सो आई एम गोइंग टू द पोर्ट एंड कितना टाइम लग रहा है उसको, लाइक होने में ऑन द वे आने में सो कितना टाइम लगेगा, तो इस टाइम पीरियड के बीच में कितना टाइम लगेगा, टाइम रिलीज सामान को रिलीज होने में कितना टाइम लगा, व्हेन आई रजिस्टर्ड द प्रोडक्ट विद द एयरपोर्ट अथॉरिटी और द पोर्ट अथॉरिटी, उसके बाद उसने कितना टाइम लिया, दैट्स आल्सो कम्स अंडर द टाइम रिलीज स्टडी. यस सो दिस इज कम्स अंडर द टाइम रिलीज स्टडी. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिपोर्ट देयर इज अ डिक्रीज इन द टाइम, लाइक वी कैन से देयर इज अ डिक्रीज इन द टाइम सम इन सम ऑफ द केसेस इट्स below to the 4 hours only. In some cases, it's like the 2 hours. In air cases, like we are taking the from the airport, so we are taking from the air flight, that comes to the 47 hours. And the import, inland wale mein, like a seaports ke through we are going through, it's taking the 48 hours. But for the air travel, it's taking only the 4 hours. So there is an improvement in the time. So we can see that there is also increasing in the ease of doing business here, because the time taking initially. Hello, now audible? Manish, Pradesh, Siddharth, Rahul, okay. So we are on a time release study. Hamara hi time release badh gaya hai yahan pe. Okay, so here the time is reduced from like initially 7 days, 5 days to the 4 hours and the 48 days respectively. In a case of air and in the case of we are like, you know, the seaports, we are taking the products. So there are the four type is mentioned here. There are the fourfold path is given for this one. So you can write these 4 points here. Advanced filing of import document, enabling pre-arrival processing. So these are the four criteria for the time release study. Kis case mein they are looking at the time. Number one, when are you advanced filing of the import document to the any other country? To usko clearance karne mein kitna time le rahe hain wo log. Then this base facilitation of cargo means some of the cargo is like a breakage products hai. There is also risk with the perishable products hai. Us products ko clear karne mein kitna time le raha hai country. Then third, benefits of a trusted client program, authorized economic operators means like a premium customers ke liye kya benefits hai. Like you will see some of the subscription, like the Hotstar premium subscriptions. Sony premium subscription. So you are allowed to watch some of the program earlier, which were going to be on TV. Usse pehle hi aap log dekh sakte hain. So similarly, a subscription program, benefits for a trusted client program. Ki jo high clients hai, unka kya benefits de rahi hai country for the cargo, like Adani, like the Ambani, kya hai. So direct port delivery facility. So these are the four program. So these can also be in the question. If there's a question on the time release study, so if they're asking about the criteria, what are the major criteria included by the government? So these 4 points can be given there. So mainly the time release study is focusing on the these 4 points for the clearance of the products there. Written. These are the like jinko authorized economic, like some of the operators which are frequently exporting the product. So they are giving a criteria authorized economic operators ki they are doing a economic transaction on frequently. And the last is a direct quote delivery facility, DPD, direct to home. Next, anchor investor. Anybody can tell the anchor investor, what is the anchor investor? एंकर इन्वेस्टर पिछले दो साल से न्यूज में है, रिसेंटली द एंकर इन्वेस्टर एग्जिट द पेटीएम, ठीक है, सो दिस वॉज द न्यूज. तो सिंपल भाषा, आसान भाषा में समझते, बताओ कौन सी करेगी? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ शिपिंग. ना ना ना, कस्टम नहीं है. ओके, सो आसान भाषा में एंकर इन्वेस्टर को समझते हैं. इफ लाइक द टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ एनी अपकमिंग आईपीओ. An example of coming IPO? Adani IPO. Let's take an example of Adani IPO. So let's take an IPO example. Okay. Okay. Unacademy is releasing its Unacademy. मतलब जिसका भी आ रहा है, आप लोग खरीद लेना जिसका भी आ रहा है. So let's the Unacademy is releasing its IPO. One day before the IPO or a two day before the IPO, they are giving a chance to the people ki aap before releasing the IPO, you can take our IPO. Offer aap pehle se hi le sakte hai, jitna share aapko lena hai, le sakte hai. But they are giving some of the condition there. You should hold the IPO for the 2 month, 3 month, 4 month. Lekin usme condition I will tell you ki kitna time period hai. Then also, they are giving a condition, ab isse pehle sale nahi kar sakte hai. So, the investor which are investing in a company before releasing of the IPO and taking the share at the price established by the company. Like if there is an Unacademy share at a 1,000 rupee price, a company is thinking we are released at a 1,000 rupee price. So the anchor investor will buy at a 1,000 rupee price before releasing in the market. But after releasing in the market, the price is down to 700. That happened with the Paytm, that happened with the Zomato. But the anchor investor is taking at a 1,000 rupee at their own risk. Yes, yes, to increase the confidence of the company in the market and to increase the confidence in the retail markets. So these are known as the anchor investor. So before going to the question, let's see the question first. Wo alag hote hain aur anchor investor alag honge. So let's go to the question first, then we will discuss the, some of the guidelines, some of the initiative with the anchor investor. Anchor investors are guaranteed an allotment of a share day before the IPO subscription process starts. So this is the definition of the anchor investor. Second, at present, the share issued to the anchor investor are locked in for a period of 60 days from the date of allotment.
Yeah.
30
days.
Confirm?
Yes.
Yes, you are right. The lock-in period, this allow anchor investor from suddenly selling shares, preventing fluctuation in the fair value. So this is the also the condition there. You cannot sell the share for a, after a particular time, you can sell it. So this is about the anchor investor. Let's see some of the things here. Anchor investors are the institutional investors who are allotted share just before an IPO. And anchor investor bound with the lock-in period with the allotment of the company. Here, the lock-in period is the 30 days. So the lock-in period for the anchor investor are the 30 days. Institutional investor like the retail investor have an option to start bidding, like a Paytm having a multiple investors. So they give a option to them if you want to become an anchor investor. If you pehle hi release se pehle hi aap allot karna chah rahe hain, khareedna chah rahe hain, you can take them. In addition, institutional investors also have the option to bid for the share at a predetermined price. Like the Paytm is setting a 1,000 rupee price for their share. So before releasing the share, there is a 6-7 anchor investors. So yahan pe boli lagengi. 1000, 1001, 2, 3, 1200, 1200, 1200, 1500. So is tarike se So there will be a bidding. So according to the bidding, the share prices will be determined there for the anchor investor. But two condition, you cannot sell before 13 days. And also you will take at a price established by the company there. Alag hota hai. So there is a lock-in period. Lock-in period is the given 30 days. So please write the 2-3 line about the anchor investors. The anchor investors are, guaranteed an allotment of shares, a day before the IPO subscription process starts. Anchor investors are bound to hold the share during the lock-in periods. And the lock-in period is 30 days, 30. Okay, so these are the, and this is why prevent the fluctuation in the shares in the market, for the prevention of fluctuation of shares in the market. So this is about the anchor investor. So this was the question. Now, National Open Access Registry. Next topic is National Open Access Registry. So before going to the registry, let's see the question. So aap apna apna dimag lagayenge aur answer batayenge. National Open Access Registry is related to, number one, all government gadget notification access to public, a library created by the UGC for all students in college, a registry of all the land records of the country, for the short-term interstate electricity transmission. All students, what will be the answer? B. D, kaun bol rahe? Answer is D. D. This is for the So National Open Access Registry is related to the for short-term interstate electricity transmission. So write two things about this ministry launched by the Ministry of Power. Yes. This is launched by Ministry of Power. Ministry of Power, Nodal Agency. Please write about the Nodal Agency. National Load Dispatch Center. LOAD. National Load Dispatch Center, operated by Power System Operation Corporation Limited. NLDC operated by Power System Operation Corporation Limited. POSOCO. POSOCO se confused nahi hona isme na. POSOCO. Power System Operation Corporation Limited. So this is the nodal agency and the launch by the Ministry of Power. Let's see about this registry hai kya. It's a centralized online platform through which the short-term open access to the interstate transmission system इट्स बीइंग मैनेज इन इंडिया. लाइक टेक एन एग्जांपल, योर दिल्ली रिक्वायर कुछ पावर शॉर्टेज की वजह से रिक्वायर सम ऑफ द अमाउंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, तो दे कैन कनेक्ट विद द नियर बाई स्टेट्स लाइक द यूपी, हरियाणा, राजस्थान, सो दे कैन टेक द पावर फ्रॉम देयर. Platform is accessible to all the stakeholders, including the participants, including the traders and the power exchange. So this is also available to these all the participants in the units. The platform also has a payment gateway, like it's a Flipkart. इन्होंने बना दी वेबसाइट. आपको चार यूनिट चाहिए, पैसा पे करो तभी देंगे. नो, कोई लोन नहीं है, कोई उधार नहीं है. तो इट्स ओनली द कैश पेमेंट, की पेमेंट गेटवे से आप लोगों को लेना है. And the benefits kya hai? It's a key facilitate faster electricity market and enable integration of renewable energy. Like government is also linking with the solar energy. Like some of the states are producing the solar energy and there's excess solar energy. And so they can transfer that excess amount of energy to the electricity deficit states. So government is focusing on the platform. And the another achievement of this government, digitally, they are converting everything to the digital formats. So the process has become very easy nowadays. It will also enable seamless market participation by the open access consumer with easier and faster access for the short-term electricity. If you see the some of the schemes of the state government, if you are installing the solar panel at your houses, if you are generating the excess of the energy through the solar panel, so the government is taking back energy and giving money to the owner. नेट मीटरिंग वी कैन से कंज्यूमर, जो कंज्यूमर से लेके उनको वापस कर रहे हैं. तो दैट्स अबाउट ऑब्जेक्टिव टू पावर ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम इंटर स्टेट पावर ट्रांसफर एवरी एनर्जी, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एनर्जी जनरेटेड फ्रॉम द एनी सोर्स. इट्स विंड भी हो सकता है, सोलर भी हो सकता है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. यस, स्टेट टू स्टेट ट्रांसफर, इंटर स्टेट वी कैन से. Also including individuals. Stakeholders में यही तो है, देखो, participants, traders, power exchange. Also, I give the example of like in the some states, government is providing, if you are installing the solar panels at their home, so they are taking the electricity from those persons and also providing the money to them. So that's also included here. Open. It's for the electricity. Yes. डिस्कॉम कंपनी, प्राइवेट कंपनी सब आएगा, क्योंकि इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल टू ट्रांसफर द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी ओनली थ्रू द गवर्नमेंट सोर्सेज. इन मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टेट्स दे आर कन्वर्टिंग देम टू द प्राइवेट ओनर्स बिकॉज देयर इज अ वेरी, हाँ, बहुत, मतलब बहुत ही खराब कंडीशंस है गवर्नमेंट डिस्कॉम्स की. हाँ, सो इफ वी कैन से लाइक इन सम ऑफ द स्टेट्स, आई एम फ्रॉम हरियाणा, देयर इज अ गुड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस स्कीम. Neo banks. Anybody can tell the example of the neo bank? Yes. Any other? Jupiter? Scooter wala Jupiter nahi. Bank Jupiter. Jupiter hai, Razor Pay hai, Lazy Pay hai. Dhani abhi to nahi hai. Yes. So neo banks is a new category of banks. What the banks are doing, they are tying up with the commercial and scheduled banks. Neo banks are tying up with the commercials and the scheduled banks and also entertaining their customers. They are providing them loans on a, like from their mobile phones. Like initially there was an issue if you are going to a bank and they are taking the longer time for the dispersal of the loans. But if you are entering your details, your PAN card number, your Aadhaar card number, they're giving loan in the 2 hours, 1 hour, even 5 minutes also. So these are the neobanks, but there is a concern regarding the neobanks because neobanks are not registered with the RBI till now. So the RBI is raising a concern. These banks are not registered with the RBI. So there should be a control on these banks. So the RBI is also taking a step for the controlling of these banks. So we need to look into what is the difference between a digital bank and the neo bank. Okay. Haan, wo bhi dekhenge. Difference between the normal bank, scheduled commercial bank and the neo bank and the difference between a digital bank as well. So we will look into the difference between the old banks here. अ नियो बैंक इज अ काइंड ऑफ डिजिटल बैंक विदाउट एनी ब्रांच. इन बैंक्स की कोई ब्रांच नहीं होती. दे आर ऑपरेटिंग थ्रू द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस और आईटी टेक्नोलॉजी के थ्रू ही ऑपरेट होते हैं. फिनटेक वी कैन सी. नियो बैंक्स आर द फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन दैट गिव कस्टमर अ चीपर अल्टरनेटिव टू द ट्रेडिशनल बैंक्स. चीपर अल्टरनेटिव कैसे? लाइक दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग मनी एट अ वेरी लोअर कॉस्ट, not a very 1-2% difference we can say. Also they are saving money. Like if you are going to physical bank, you are traveling, you are spending money here, you are going, but ek din mein kaam nahi karke de rahe hain, roz bula rahe hain, aaj ye nahi, aaj ye nahi, aaj ye nahi. So it's also taking a huge money aapko jaane mein. Internally commission chahiye. If you are taking a loan over 2 lakh 5 lakh, bank manager bolega mujhe 1% commission chahiye tabhi main loan disburse karunga. That's also the reason. So people are moving toward the fintech because it's easily available on your mobile phones. Yes. वो भी मैं आपको बता. Let I give the example of it. You are using credit card. How many of you are using the credit card? Okay, theek hai. In the credit card, if you are using the credit card, there is a 45 to 50 days free periods. Yeah, 45 to 50 days money you can use without any interest rate. If you are going beyond that, they are charging you a rate of 12%. If you are paying the minimum due of that card. If you are not paying also the minimum due, they will charge you the 48%. Okay. So this is the area of the credit card. These are released by commercial schedule bank. Similarly, there is a case of the fintech. If the fintech is disbursing the loan to you, in that case, there is a term and condition. Jo hum log kabhi nahi padte usko tick kar dete hain. So it's not the issue of the fintech. It's the issue of the customer. They are not reading the term and condition given by the fintech. Even in the case of the schedule and commercial bank, if agar aap mein se kisi ne loan liya hai ya nahi bhi liya hai, if there is an area of the commercial and the schedule banks, if you're taking a loan of 2 lakh and there's an EMI of 20,000 per month, you are not paying your EMI, they will add it into the compound interest. If there's an interest of 2,000 on the 20,000, that will also add it into the principal there. So the same concept with the neo banks. So what is the difference? Difference is the interest rate they are offering. The difference is the time periods. They are taking very less time period to do that. And the efficient, we can say. Yes, financial, aapko kahin jaane ka zarurat hi nahi pada. At your doorstep, you are taking the loans as well. Aur bina kisi cheez ke, aap bina documentation ke bhi isko use kar sakte hain. तो यहाँ पे मेनली आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस यूज हो रहा है. थोड़े दिन में चैट जीपीटी भी आ जाएगा. ओके. तो इनको मेनली नाम दिया गया चैलेंजर बैंक. चैलेंजर बैंक बिकॉज दे आर नॉट रजिस्टर्ड विद द आरबीआई. सो देयर इज अ इशू इन द ऑपरेशन एज वेल. इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ दिस देयर आर सम ऑफ द चाइनीज फर्म्स आल्सो एंटर इनटू द इंडियन मार्केट्स एंड दे आर एक्सप्लॉइटिंग देयर कस्टमर्स. इफ दे आर गिविंग अ लोन ऑफ द 5,000, दे आर टेकिंग देम फ्रॉम द 5 लाख. अगर ऐसा नहीं करते तो बिकॉज लाइक दिस इज देयर इज अ स्टोरी ऑन द डिस्कवरी रिलेटेड टू द मनी माफिया. दे आर शोइंग द सम ऑफ द गुड स्टोरी ऑफ द इंडियन फाइनेंशियल मार्केट. इन दैट दे आर शोइंग लाइक द सम ऑफ द कस्टमर आर टेकिंग अ लोन ऑफ 5,000-6,000, बट दैट चाइनीज आर बी टेकिंग द एक्सेस ऑफ कंप्लीट योर फोन, योर फोटोज, योर कॉल रिकॉर्ड्स, योर मैसेजेस, एंड दे आर टेकिंग सम ऑफ द सेंसिटिव इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम योर मोबाइल फोन. इफ यू आर डिनाइंग वी विल नॉट पे मोर देन द 5,000, दे आर start sharing your information to the other person, and also by changing the some of the concept of the information. So us case mein they are taking, and the person is like ye kya ho raha hai, so they are also going to the suicide in that case. So ye aisa is cases mein ho raha. So we can say it's a negative side of the, if the market is unoperated, if the neo banks are unoperated, so there should be a operation hona chahiye. It should be operated by the RBI. So this is a concern of the RBI. So this is a good concern as well, we can say. Cyber crime kind of, yes. So that's why the after those incident, the government of India take the action and they are closed down almost 60-70 Chinese apps or like there was a news also closing of the Chinese apps, and some of the apps also included to the financial purpose there. अभी कोई भी रेगुलेशन नहीं इन द केस ऑफ लाइक देयर इज अ मिनिमम रेगुलेशन इनिशियली इफ यू वांट टू स्टार्ट अ फिनटेक देयर इज अ मिनिमम रेगुलेशन ऑफ कि आपको इतना अमाउंट होना चाहिए फॉर स्टार्टिंग अ फिनटेक और आपको किसी मिनिस्ट्री के अंडर रजिस्टर्ड होना है लाइक अ मिटी वी कैन से मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इफ यू आर यूजिंग द प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस और द आईटी टेक्नोलॉजी यू शुड बी रजिस्टर्ड अंडर द मिटी एंड यू बट यू आर डूइंग उस केस में अगर आपको बाद में पेमेंट्स बैंक्स के लिए जाना है उसके बाद आपको लोन डिसबर्सल के लिए जाना है या फिर किसी और चीज के लिए जाना है तो देन द रोल ऑफ द आरबीआई कम देयर. हाँ सारे सारे लोग सारी एप्स अनकंट्रोल्ड नहीं है बिकॉज वी सी द सम ऑफ द एड्स देयर लाइक एड्स ऑफ द ऑल्सो लाइक पेटीएम का ही एड्स देख लेते हैं. पेटीएम का एड्स है इसके साथ साथ सिंपल इज द ऐप विच आर प्रोवाइडिंग द लोन यू आर गेटिंग द नेम ऑफ द अर्ली सैलरी ऐसा कुछ है. तो मैनी मैनी एप्स आर देयर. सम ऑफ द एप्स आर सपोर्टेड बाय देयर पेरेंट कंपनी. वी कैन नॉट से दीज आर द इंडिविजुअल एप्स. सम ऑफ द एप्स आर सपोर्टेड बाय देयर पेरेंट कंपनी लाइक सिंपल इट्स अ ऐप ऑफ द एक्सिस बैंक सपोर्टेड बाय द एक्सिस बैंक. तो देयर विल बी द लेस रेगुलेटरी इशू. Similarly, the Paytm is also a Paytm payment bank. These are supported by their parent company. So there will be a lesser issue. But these apps are giving loan after checking your documents, after complete clearance of your documents, and not providing loan immediately. Like the Chinese apps. They are providing within the 5 minutes, 5,000 rupees within the 5 minutes. If you think ki 5,000 hote kya hai, lekin kuch kuch jagah pe, even the rupee 100 is also matter there. तो वो वाले लोग ही इनका सबसे ज्यादा दिक्कत प्रॉब्लम्स होती है. यस यस यस. नाउ इसी केस में नियो बैंक का कंसेप्ट आया है न्यूज में कि इनका कंट्रोल क्या है. व्हाट इज द कंट्रोल फंक्शन ऑफ द आरबीआई इज हियर एंड व्हाट इज द आरबीआई डूइंग व्हाट द थिंग्स. हाँ हाँ वो अनकंट्रोल्ड क्यों है इसके लिए अभी इफ यू सी द आईबीसी इज आल्सो रिलीज सम ऑफ द गाइडलाइंस रिलेटेड टू सम ऑफ द एडवर्टाइजमेंट टू द डिफरेंट प्लेटफॉर्म्स. सो अभी आईबीसी का भी इस पे गाइडलाइंस आया है. ठीक है सो लेट्स सी द बैंक डू नॉट हैव अ बैंक लाइसेंस ऑफ देयर ओन बट रिलाई ऑन द बैंक पार्टनर टू ऑफर लाइसेंस सर्विस लाइक देयर इज अ लार्जर बैंक लाइक एक्सिस बैंक और द एसबीआई. एसबीआई तो नहीं देगा. मे बी द अदर बैंक. हाँ शेडो बैंकिंग का एग्जाम्पल वी कैन से दिस इज पार्ट ऑफ इट बिकॉज द आरबीआई डज नॉट अलाउ बैंक टू बी द 100% डिजिटल. आरबीआई ने इनको अलाउ नहीं किया है बट देर इज डूइंग द फंक्शन ऑफ अ बैंक. दे आर गिविंग लोन टू द बैंक चार्जिंग द इंटरेस्ट सो इट्स अ फंक्शन ऑफ अ बैंक फॉर एनबीएफसी बट दे आर नॉट रजिस्टर्ड देयर. हाँ दोनों केसेस में क्योंकि डिजिटल there is also a difference there. If there is a digital bank mein humne dekha tha digital bank units hain and the money are digital banks. If you are establishing a digital bank there should be your head office should be there. Head office mein aapke sare employees jo control hai sab kuch hota hai. In banks ka kuch nahi hai. They are operating from a room there. From the Bangalore valley se they are controlling the some of the products there. तो इनके लिए कुछ एक conditions होगा. You should be registered under the RBI Act of 1934. If you are providing a digital service, like some of the international bank, I can say the example of DBS. DBS is operating in the India and one of the largest bank of the world and also the one of the finest bank of the world, we can say, the Bank of the Singapore. So that's also providing the digital service and it's a digital bank it is. So it should be registered under the RBI Act ki aapko operation karne diya ja raha as a foreign bank. So wo cheez unke saath nahi hai. So there is a difference, yes. Related to RBI Act name 1934 mein there is amendment. Okay, the RBI remains resolute in prioritizing bank physical presence and has spoken about the need of digital banking service. So unhone bola ki hame zarurat to hai lekin we cannot hum unko operate karne nahi de sakte without any regulation. So we are doing a regulation on that. So there is some of the differences. Let's see about the सम ऑफ द डिफरेंसेस ट्रेडिशनल बैंक्स और नियो बैंक्स में क्या क्या मेजर डिफरेंसेस है। नंबर वन, सर्विस प्लेटफॉर्म को लेके, फिजिकल बैंकिंग एस्टेब्लिशमेंट चाहिए होता है शेड्यूल कमर्शियल बैंक्स के लिए, बट वेब एंड मोबाइल सर्विसेज आर एनफ हियर। यू आर टेकिंग द लोन फ्रॉम योर एप्स, यू आर टेकिंग द लोन फ्रॉम द वेबसाइट्स। मार्केट एंटिटी अप टू 100 ईयर एगो, मतलब अप टू 100 ईयर पहले से ही चलते आ रहे हैं, लाइक 1934 से पहले से भी बैंक्स रनिंग है, लेकिन अभी इनिशियली आफ्टर 2010 दे आर स्टार्ट रनिंग इट। अगर आप देखोगे 2015 से पहले ऐसे कोई प्रोडक्ट्स नहीं थे, वो द रियल प्रोडक्ट वी कैन से इन द मार्केट, बट नाउ इट्स मार्केट इज फ्लडेड विद द फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट्स। क्लाइंट रिलेशंस लॉन्ग टर्म्स होता है इन पर्सन विद द माइनर चेंजेस। आपको बैंक जाना पड़ता है, बैंक एम्प्लॉय के साथ झगड़ा करना पड़ता है, अभी मेरा पैसा दे दे, रजिस्टर्ड है, बट इन दैट केस फ्लेक्सिबल है वर्चुअली। आजकल तो KYC भी आपके फोन कैमरा से ही हो जाती है, तो जीरो इंटरफेस विद द बैंकिंग एम्प्लॉय, बट हेयर द बैंकिंग एम्प्लॉय प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल। देन कस्टमर सपोर्ट इन पर्सन, फोन ऑनलाइन, फोन से तो देते ही नहीं है, वो कहते हैं बैंक किया जाओ एक बार, तो यहाँ पे फोन ऑनलाइन से ही सब कुछ होता है। एंड द फी, हाई फीस है, कॉम्प्लेक्स है, बिकॉज द एसेट्स चार्जेज आर इंक्लूडेड देयर। इफ द SBI हैविंग द थाउजेंड्स ऑफ ब्रांच इन द कंट्री, तो उसका एसेट चार्ज है, रेंट चार्ज है, ऑपरेशन चार्जेज है, तो यहाँ पे ऑपरेशन चार्जेज बहुत कम हो जाता है क्योंकि एक रूम से ही बैंक को चला रहे हैं। So that comes under the low and transparent banking. Banking license उनके पास है, इनके पास नहीं है, या फिर supported by the third party bank. Third party bank where you can use our license and you can give some money to us from their profit. Then bank officers, yes, offices होते हैं इनके, like जहाँ पे पूरे देखोगे हर जगह offices है, लेकिन यहाँ पे इनके offices नहीं है। Confirmation process, फिजिकल बैंक्स टेक अ लॉन्गर देन 10 डेज 15 डेज इन द मंथ्स, बट दे आर टेकिंग द इंस्टेंट लोन, लाइक अ डिलीवरी ऑफ 10 मिनट्स, लोन इन द 5 मिनट्स ऑल्सो। यस, ओके, सो RBI वर्किंग ग्रुप ने क्या सजेस्ट किया था रिलेटेड टू द नियो बैंक। दे सजेस्टेड सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। ऑपरेशन ऑफ डिजिटल बैंक एंड द नियो बैंक शुड बी कवर्ड अंडर द RBI रेगुलेशंस। मोर ऑफ डिजिटल ओनली NBFC टू बी एनकरेज एंड ग्राउंड वर्क फॉर डिजिटल बैंक शुड बी लेड। तो ये कह रहे कि NBFC को ही प्रमोट किया जाए उस केस में। एंड देर शुड बी कंक्रीट वर्क जब हम उसको अलाउ कर रहे हैं किसी भी डिजिटल बैंक के लिए। अवर द टॉप एंटिटी पोजिंग एज अ बैंक इज प्रमोशनल मटीरियल शुड बी प्रोहिबिटेड फ्रॉम डूइंग सो। इफ एनी एंटिटी इज गिविंग द एड्स अगेन एंड अगेन इन द गूगल प्ले स्टोर, इन द यूट्यूब और इवन सम ऑफ द मोबाइल फोन्स, दे आर गिविंग द एड्स ऑफ द लोन्स अगेन एंड अगेन, दे शुड कीप एन आई ऑन दोज एड्स, सो दीज एड्स शुड बी प्रोहिबिटेड। Then banks that partner with the OTT entity must set an operational code for them. The OTT entities ke liye hain, they are showing the ads there, they should be a targeted. RBI sandbox should have a category for running pilot projects on the digital lenders. Like e-rupee ke liye pilot projects chale hain. Similarly, for there should be a pilot project for the these type of the bank also. Without the pilot project, you cannot run over the country. So these can be the exploitative for the person jinko koi knowledge hi nahi hai. Or they are having the less digital knowledge, so these bank can exploit them. Okay, so this is about the neo bank. So what is the difference between the traditional bank and the neo bank? Traditional bank, scheduled commercial bank registered under the RBI Act, and the neo bank. Funding and the customer trust. Customer trust neo banks ke paas nahi hai, but the physical bank having the customer trust, like your father's mother going to bank, the bank employee know them. Aaiye Sharma ji, aaiye ye ji, aap baithiye chai piyenge nahi. So this kind of relation with the शेड्यूल कमर्शियल बैंक, बट विद हमें जानते ही नहीं है कि इन द केस ऑफ नियो बैंक कौन है, कौन लोन दे रहा है, क्या है क्या नहीं है, वी डोंट नो। देन द इनोवेशन, इन द केस ऑफ द इनोवेशन नियो बैंक्स आर ऑन अ हायर साइड, दे आर यूजिंग द डिजिटल टेक, दे आर यूजिंग अ टेक्नोलॉजी, दे आर डिस्बर्सिंग लोन वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली, और जरूरत के हिसाब से नियो बैंक इज द नीड ऑफ द आवर्स, वी कैन से कि हमें इनिशियली जल्दी चाहिए। आज किसी के साथ पेशेंस नहीं है, इन द UPSC प्रिपरेशन 2 महीने हुए नहीं सर, मेरे से नहीं हो रहा, या मेरे कुछ समझ ही नहीं आ रहा, क्या करूं, रूटीन नहीं बन पा रहा, ये नहीं हो पा रहा। तो इन द केस ऑफ लोन, आपको कोई 5 मिनट में लोन दे रहा है, कोई दे रहा है 50 दिन में, तो यू विल ऑब्वियसली अट्रैक्ट टू आर द 5 मिनट्स, इवन देर विल बी लिटिल बिट रिस्क, आप लोग जाओ कोई नहीं, आप 45 दिन में मैं इतना अर्न कर लूंगा एक्स्ट्रा, दिस टाइप ऑफ थिंकिंग इज टूडे। देन अंडरसर्व बाय द ट्रेडिशनल बैंक्स, उस एरिया को टारगेट किया जाता है जहां पे ब्रांचेज नहीं है। So why the RBI come with the concept of digital bank units to counter these banks as well? We studied the digital bank unit in the last class. So they are focusing the where the services are not available by the physical bank. So the RBI is establishing the digital bank units. So the digital products of the banking system can reach to those banks. वेंचर कैपिटल एंड द प्राइवेट इक्विटी इन्वेस्टर्स, वेंचर कैपिटल्स ज्यादा होते हैं नियो बैंक्स में, क्योंकि सम टाइम दे आर कन्वर्टिंग द ब्लैक मनी टू द व्हाइट मनी, एंड ऑल्सो दे आर द अननोन इन्वेस्टर की हाँ भाई जिन्होंने इन्वेस्ट किया दे आर टेकिंग द प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम द बैंक, उनको उसके रनिंग से कोई इशू नहीं है. बट इन द केस ऑफ द शेड्यूल्ड कमर्शियल बैंक गवर्नमेंट बैकिंग भी होती है, ऑल्सो द इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ द प्राइवेट फर्म्स आर देयर, बट दे शुड बी द क्लीन. इस बैंक में इस बंदे का इतना इन्वेस्टमेंट है, इट शुड बी द क्लियर देयर. स्मार्टफोन पेनिट्रेशन, जैसे जैसे स्मार्टफोन बढ़ा है मार्केट में वैसे वैसे नए टेक प्रोडक्ट्स आना शुरू हुए हैं. इफ देयर वाज नो स्मार्टफोन बिफोर 2012-13 तो देयर वाज द लाइक अ वेरी लेस टेक प्रोडक्ट इन द मार्केट, बट आफ्टर द स्मार्टफोन पेनिट्रेशन द टेक प्रोडक्ट इन द मार्केट इज इंक्रीजिंग. देन आफ्टर द चैलेंजेस क्या है, नंबर वन फुलफिलिंग द नीड्स ऑफ अ सेगमेंट ऑफ द मार्केट, किसी एक पर्टिकुलर सेगमेंट को ही फोकस कर रहे हैं, विच आर हैविंग अ लेस फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी तो दे आर फोकसिंग ऑन दोज पर्संस. देन रेगुलेटरी हर्डल्स, रजिस्टर्ड ही नहीं है आरबीआई के साथ, सो देयर इज अ रेगुलेटरी प्रॉब्लम ऑल्सो. इम्पर्सनल, नियो बैंक डोंट हैव अ फिजिकल ब्रांच नहीं है, कस्टमर नहीं है, उनको पता ही नहीं कहाँ जाना है. मान लो यू आर टेकिंग अ लोन एंड आपने लोन को दे दिया, आपको दोबारा लेना है, एंड दे आर ब्लॉकिंग यूर अकाउंट्स, तो आप उसको ओपन करने के लिए कहाँ पे जाएंगे? तो देयर इज अ नो चांस देयर कि आप कुछ भी फोन उठाना बंद कर देंगे, आपका नंबर ब्लॉक कर देंगे. इन दैट केस यू कैन नॉट विजिट टू द ब्रांच. Then the limited services, they are also providing some of the limited services like giving the loans only, or we can say like giving the some of the online transaction, ki aap Flipkart pe transact kar sakte hain ya phir Amazon pe kar sakte hain, this type of services they are providing. Unke phone se
register
karte hain to log the account number details nahi, only the PAN number and the Aadhaar number. Like they are giving in options, if you want money directly into the bank account, they will give money into the app wallet, like a Paytm ka wallet hai, they will credit money into the Paytm wallet. So then from the Paytm wallet, you can transfer money to your bank. This type of services they are providing. Aadhaar mein sab details hai aaj ke time mein. So they will take everything. Yeah. They are taking the sum of the like, जैसे ही आप उनको उल्लू बनाने की कोशिश करेंगे आपका क्रेडिट स्कोर होता है, जैसे सम क्रेडिट स्कोर, सीबीएल, सिबिल स्कोर बोलते हैं, अगर वो नहीं दोगे तो सिबिल स्कोर रीच टू 200, 300, 400 तो आपको जिंदगी में कभी लोन नहीं मिलेगा, क्योंकि सिबिल आपने रीपे नहीं किया, यू आर नॉट रीपेइंग द लोन्स यू आर टेकिंग फ्रॉम द एनी कंपनी, क्रेडिट स्कोर खराब हो जाएगा. लो कॉस्ट वो इतना डिस्पर्स नहीं करते, वो डिस्पर्स करेंगे 2,000, 5,000, 10,000, इससे ज्यादा नहीं करते. बिकॉज दे आर टाइंग अप विद दिस कंपनी विच आर रिलीजिंग द सिबिल्स को, सबसे पहले उन्हीं के साथ टाई अप होता है उनका. देन द लो कॉस्ट, लाइक नियो बैंक आर प्रोवाइडिंग द लोन एट द लो कॉस्ट, वी डिस्कस अबाउट इट. कन्वीनियंस है, इजी है कि आप आराम से घर बैठे सोते सोते भी लोन ले सकते हैं. देन द स्पीड, दीज आर लाइक वी कैन से दीज आर लाइक अ स्प्रिंट एंड स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया लाइक द मैराथन, उन्हें लंबा भागना है तो दे आर टेकिंग अ स्लो प्रोसेस. ये स्प्रिंट है, कल बंद भी हो सकते हैं, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा, बट दे आर गिविंग द लोन्स. ट्रांसपेरेंसी, इन द शेड्यूल कमर्शियल बैंक देयर इज अ ट्रांसपेरेंसी, कि आप आएंगे मैनेजर से मिलेंगे, डॉक्यूमेंट दिखाएंगे, फिजिकल डॉक्यूमेंटेशन होगा, सब कुछ होगा. यहाँ कोई ट्रांसपेरेंसी नहीं है. सम इन द सम अदर केस दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग द लोन विदाउट अ डॉक्यूमेंट एज वेल, लाइक द चाइनीज ऐप, वो आपके फोन का ही डेटा ले लेते हैं डॉक्यूमेंट से ज्यादा, ठीक है. तो डीप इनसाइट्स, तो दे शुड बी मोर फोकस ऑन द कि बैंकिंग सर्विसेज कैसे रेगुलेट हो रही है इंडिया में, तो उसके भी लिए भी थोड़ा सा इश्यू है अभी. फोस्टरिंग इफेक्टिव एनर्जी ट्रांजिशन 2022, this report is released by maine bataya tha Atish. So this is the report released by the World Economic Forum related to the energy requirement in the future. So the World Economic Forum is find out that there is not good efforts relating to the future requirement of the energy. They are taking a question marking the some of the process taken by the governments, it not in the India and also the other country as well. So they are focusing ki aage kya kya requirement hoga, to uske liye energy ka production kaise hona hai. So also they are suggesting the some way for the energy production there. So the energy transition not keeping the pace with the growing climate urgency and the recent compounded disruption in the post pandemic surge. इन्होंने कुछ एग्जाम्पल भी दिए लाइक द रशिया यूक्रेन क्राइसिस के केसेस में देयर इज अ सम ऑफ द डिसरप्शन ऑफ द पेट्रोलियम प्रोडक्ट्स सो देयर इज अ डिसरप्शन इन द एनर्जी एज वेल इन अ केस ऑफ कोविड देयर इज आल्सो डिसरप्शन इन द एनर्जी एज वेल सो देयर गिविंग अ सम ऑफ एग्जाम्पल कि ऐसा हो रहा है तो मे बी इट कैन बी हैपन इन द अदर वे एज वेल एंड देयर आल्सो गिविंग द एग्जाम्पल कि कंट्रीज आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन द 4-5 कंट्रीज फॉर द एनर्जी लाइक दे आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन द ऑयल प्रोड्यूसिंग कंट्री दे आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द रशिया So they are also targeting it in the future if they are not giving energy to the some developing country. So how, what will be the happen there? So the report is also highlighted these concerns there. So what is the important thing there? The reports related kisse hai, mainly related to energy and released by the World Economic Forum. This is the two points. Isse jyada nahi poochte hain. Then what are the recommendations given by the World Economic Forum here? Number one, climate commitment and the long-term vision. There should be, whenever you are producing the energy, it's a renewable or the non-renewable energy, the climate should be in the mind. There should be the lesser effect on the climate whenever you are producing any energy. And the long-term visions means you are, aisa nahi hai ki neo banks ki tarah aaj loan diya, kal band ho gaye. The process should be the continue. There should be the very less effect on the environment. And the process is sustainable according to the sustainable development goal. Then holistic approach on the transition imperatives. Like the some of the countries are transitioning from the renewable source to non-renewable source to the renewable sources. So there should be a good approach. Aisa nahi hai ki abruptly nahi hona, like the demonetization ki tarah. Demonetization was an abrupt action. There should be a very effect on the economy hua. So they are saying ki abruptly nahi bolna ki kal se pura India renewable pe chalega. There should be a good approach. So there should be a holistic approach. इस प्रोसेस में फर्स्ट फेज में इन स्टेट्स में इस सिटी में वी आर रनिंग द प्रोजेक्ट्स वी आर डेवलपिंग द सम ऑफ द चार्जिंग स्टेशन देयर लाइक द एनीबडी कैन टेल द फर्स्ट चार्जिंग स्टेशन कोई रोड है इंडिया में वेयर द कंप्लीट ई व्हीकल फैसिलिटी इज अवेलेबल ई व्हीकल चार्जिंग स्टेशन इज अवेलेबल ऑन द कंप्लीट रोड आपके आस पास ही है दिल्ली चंडीगढ़ हाईवे दिल्ली चंडीगढ़ हाईवे इज द फर्स्ट हाईवे इन द कंट्री विच आर हैविंग द फैसिलिटी ऑफ द कंप्लीट चार्जिंग ई चार्जिंग फॉर द व्हीकल्स ओके सो एनर्जी डाइवर्सिटी एंड द सिक्योरिटी हियर द एनर्जी डाइवर्सिटी मीन्स देयर शुड बी द वेरियस सोर्सेज नॉट डिपेंडेंट ऑन अ सिंगल सोर्स लाइक मे बी द फ्रॉम सन एनर्जी सोलर एनर्जी मे बी द विंड एनर्जी मे बी द जियोथर्मल एनर्जी एंड द एनर्जी फ्रॉम द कोल एज वेल So there should be the multiple ways. There not should be not be the single ways. Some of the countries are dependent completely on the coal energy, completely on the petroleum energy. But the report is saying there should be a multiple way for the energy dependence. If there is a close down of the one way, then there should be the another way for the energy there. Supply side intervention and the demand side efficiency. They are giving the example of the Russia-Ukraine war and the timeline of the COVID. At that time, in the COVID time, there was a disruption of the supply chain. एंड ऑल्सो द लेसर डिमांड क्योंकि डिमांड कम था और सप्लाई चेन डिस्ट्रप्शन था तो काम चल गया क्योंकि दोनों एक दूसरे के ठीक है अगर उल्टा होता डिमांड ज्यादा है सप्लाई चेन डिस्ट्रप्शन है देन व्हाट विल बी द हैपन द प्राइस विल बी द स्काई रॉकेट देयर 100 लीटर है 1000 लीटर हो जाएगा पेट्रोल इन दैट केस तो देर शुड बी कंप्लीटली फोकस इफ देर इज एनी नेचुरल डाइजेस्टर इन एनी कंट्री लाइक अभी टर्की में अर्थक्वेक की वजह से द टर्की एंड वन ऑफ द सीरिया is completely almost damaged in that case what should be the government focus ki energy ke liye kahan se or tie up should be very necessary with the country so they should be aise country ke dependent hona chahiye jo aapko aise time mein bhi energy provide kare regulatory framework what is the regulatory framework set up by the government of india or the government of any country for the establishment of the new renewable energy in the country tie ups kya hain पब्लिक प्राइवेट पार्टनरशिप में कितने प्रोजेक्ट आप चला रहे हैं आपके कंट्री के अकॉर्डिंग क्या एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी है देयर शुड बी कंप्लीटेड देयर क्लीन डिमांड कितना रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी का डिमांड है आपके कंट्री में तो इट शुड बी वेरी लेस वेस्टेड एंड शुड बी द एनर्जी शुड बी लाइक अच्छे से यूज होना चाहिए एफिशियंसी अच्छा होना चाहिए तो दीज आर सम ऑफ द पॉइंट्स हाईलाइटेड बाय द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम दीज ऑल पॉइंट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द मेंस ओनली बट फॉर द प्रीलिम्स इट शुड बी Who released this report and what is the major criteria in the report? So these are the two important. So यही points आपको याद आने चाहिए ना वहाँ पे आप क्या लिख के आओगे less energy efficiency. तो वहाँ पे clean demand होना चाहिए. तो keywords का बहुत ज़्यादा role play होता है in your mains answer writing. If you are making the side heading with the good keywords, तो examiner अंदर का पड़ेगा ही नहीं. तो वो कीवर्ड्स को देखेगा कि इतने अच्छे कीवर्ड्स यूज किए तो अंदर तो अच्छा ही होगा। तो उस तरीके से दे शुड बी लाइक, ऐसा होना चाहिए कि आप कीवर्ड्स बहुत अच्छे यूज कर रहे हैं अपने आंसर्स में। तो बताइए कौन कौन सा रिपोर्ट्स रिलीज करता है वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम? पांच या छह रिपोर्ट्स रिलीज की जाती है वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम से। तो बिफोर टेलिंग इट, लेट्स डू दिस क्वेश्चन। दिस वाज अ क्वेश्चन इन द 2017। सो हाउ द क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क, सर विल यू प्रोवाइड दिस पीपीटी? यस मनीष, आई विल प्रोवाइड। सो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग गिव्स द ग्लोबल जेंडर गैप इंडेक्स? इफ द क्वेश्चन ऑन द रिपोर्ट दिस काइंड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन विल बी देयर। दिस इज अ टाइप वन, इट इज रिलीज बाय द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम। आपकी बार आएगा क्योंकि रिपोर्ट्स रिलीज ही नहीं हुई कोविड की वजह से। इंडिया रैंकिंग ऑफ ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस इंडेक्स इज समथिंग समथिंग इन द न्यूज डिक्लेयर बाय द रैंकिंग वर्ल्ड बैंक। अभी रिपोर्ट ही बंद हो गई है वैसे तो, ना ठीक है। इन 2019 दे गिव द 3-4 पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम द दिस रिपोर्ट कि ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस में क्या क्या इंक्लूड होता है। सो देर शुड बी क्राइटेरिया एज वेल। सो वेन एवर वी आर रीडिंग अ रिपोर्ट देर शुड बी नो अबाउट द वट आर द क्राइटेरिया ऑफ रिलीजिंग अ रिपोर्ट। किस किस बेसिस पे उन्होंने रिलीज की है, लाइक अ टाइम रिलीज स्टडी। देर आर 3 क्राइटेरिया देयर 4 क्राइटेरिया देयर। तो क्या क्या क्राइटेरिया है वो भी आप लोगों को पता होना चाहिए। तो प्लीज राइट अबाउट द सम ऑफ द रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम। नंबर वन एनर्जी ट्रांजिशन इंडेक्स। नंबर टू ग्लोबल कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस रिपोर्ट। नंबर थर्ड ग्लोबल आईटी रिपोर्ट, आईटी इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, ग्लोबल आईटी रिपोर्ट। दिस इज रिलीज बाय वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम प्लस इनसीड, INSEED। INSEED plus Cornell University. So these are three organizations which are involved. Cornell University. World Economic Forum, INSEED and the Cornell University. World IT, Global IT Report, IT. Global IT Report. Fourth, Global Gender Gap Report. ग्लोबल जेंडर गैप रिपोर्ट। नंबर फाइव ग्लोबल रिस्क रिपोर्ट। नंबर सिक्स ग्लोबल ट्रैवल एंड टूरिज्म रिपोर्ट। दीज आर द सिक्स रिपोर्ट्स विच आर रिलीज बाय द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम। Now let's come to the front running. What is the meaning of the front running? आगे भागना। किससे? So this term is related to the capital market. In the front running, if any company is a, I am a share market company, that's you are owning a share market company. So you are having a internal decision of any big company ki Tata mein ye hone wala hai. Aapko pehle se hi pata hai is information ke baare mein. So if you know the some internal information of a company in your share company, share market company, so there is some difference between the insider trading and the front running. Well, theek hai. So in that case, you will tell that report or that information to the someone else. And you will said if you buy the share of that company, I should will take 1% commission from those share, but you will gain 10-20% in the next few days. So the information released by the people in from the company, it comes under the front running. कि आपको पहले से information पता था and you are doing उसके basis पे या पूरा काम कर रहे हैं. Like किसी ने series देखी है 1992 scam, अर्शद मेहता, so उसमें भी front running ही हुआ है. ठीक है. So front running, it's a practice dealing in security on advance information of an upcoming transaction that could be affect its price and movement in share market, and it is illegal in India. And SEBI categorized front running as a form of market manipulation and insider trading, because a person who commits a front running activity expects security price movement based on the known public information. Before publishing any news in the newspaper, the person knows what is going to be happen next. And this is mainly from the company side itself. If somebody working in the Reliance industry, somebody working in the Adani, so they know ki what should be happen, which are on the higher post. So they are dealing with this share market company. Mujhe itna paisa toh main information dunga. So this kind of trading is also there. SEBI has investigated and penalized several funds houses and the fund managers in the past for the front running. So the question isi tarike ka aayega, front running hai kya? It is related to char options honge. Ek bhagne wala option bhi hoga. So isse related hi question will be there. So let's see kaise kaam karta hai front running. Ye aap mein se koi teen log baithe hain, front men mein teen hai. इन्वेस्टमेंट टीम्स है, ए फंड आइडेंटिटी है स्टॉक एंड डिसाइड टू बाय. कोई स्टॉक्स के बारे में बात चल रही है कि अदानी विल रिलीज द एफपीओ एंड वी विल बाय इट. देन अंदर से कोई इनसाइडर ट्रेडिंग करते हुए आया, फंड हाउस स्टाफर इसने सुन लिया इनका इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड दिस कम टू द पीपल कि ऐसा होने वाला है, कि ब्रोकर के पास गया कि ऐसा होगा कि बंदे को पकड़ के लाओ. लाइक अगर मार्केट में जाओगे तो रूम दिखाने वाले आ जाते हैं, तो उनका भी एक चेन होता है. ये आपको एक पास पकड़ेगा, दूसरे का छोड़ देगा, तीसरे का छोड़ देगा. सिमिलरली उस बंदे को इन्फॉर्मेशन है, उस बंदे को इन्फॉर्मेशन कि वहां पे रूम खाली है, इस बंदे को इन्फॉर्मेशन है कि इस कंपनी का प्राइस बढ़ने वाला है, तो ये इन्फॉर्मेशन तुरंत उसके पास भेज देगा ब्रोकर के पास, एंड ब्रोकर किसी क्लाइंट को लेके आ जाएगा यहाँ पे. तो दैट विल फंड हाउस बाय ऑर्डर विद द ब्रोकर. तो ये क्लाइंट पकड़ लिया, तो ये आप जिसको रूम लेना उसने उसको पकड़ लिया. तो सिमिलरली क्लाइंट विल गिव द इन्फॉर्मेशन, दिस टेक द लाइक इन्होंने शेयर खरीद लिया, अगले दिन देखा कि शेयर प्राइस बढ़ गया, then broker will tell you अगर आज आप रूम नहीं लोगे तो कल 15,000 में लग जाएगा ये, तो आप जाके उस रूम को ले लोगे. तो सिमिलरली ये जाके शेयर प्राइस को ले लेगा और नेक्स्ट डे प्राइस विल इंक्रीज देयर. तो दिस इज द एग्जांपल ऑफ हाँ बता देता हूँ. दोनों को फायदा है. नुकसान किसको है? जिनको इन्फॉर्मेशन पता नहीं है. तो देयर इज अ इशू विद द कस्टमर. तो यहाँ पे रोल किसका आ जाता है? सेबी के साथ साथ कस्टमर के साथ कौन डील करता है? कंज्यूमर्स प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट. तो इनसाइडर ट्रेडिंग में थर्ड पार्टी इन्वॉल्व नहीं होता. मान लो कि आप किसी कंपनी में काम कर रहे हैं एंड आप 5-7 लोगों का ग्रुप बना हुआ है कंपनी के बारे में, आपने उस कंपनी के शेयर भी खरीदे हुए हैं और आपके पास इन्फॉर्मेशन है, तो आप उस इन्फॉर्मेशन को ब्रोकर को दे दोगे, ब्रोकर अपने आप सेटलमेंट करेगा जो भी उसको करना है. तो इस केस में आपका इन्वॉल्वमेंट, आपका कमीशन सब कुछ है एज ए जनरल. ऑन द वे वी कैन से कि रिजल्ट दोनों का सेम है, बट प्रोसेस दोनों का अलग है. तो यही दोनों में डिफरेंस है. और दोनों इनसाइडर ट्रेडिंग और फ्रंट रनिंग दोनों ही बैन है इंडिया में, तो दोनों ही केस में इशूज नहीं होते होंगे. मतलब डिफरेंस, क्योंकि इलीगल है, इलीगल का कोई डिफरेंस नहीं होता. इलीगल इज इलीगल इन बोथ द केस, बोथ द कंसेप्ट्स आर इलीगल. एक में पूरा प्रोसेस, लाइक इन द फ्रंट रनिंग देयर इज अ प्रोसेस, लाइक जो भी न्यूज होगी, जो ब्रोकर हाउस कंपनी है उसके पास पूरा न्यूज है, दो जो आर रनिंग दीज कंपनी, वहां से इंफॉर्मेशन स्टार्ट हो रहा है. इनसाइडर ट्रेडिंग में इंफॉर्मेशन स्टार्ट हो रहा है जो उस कंपनी के बंदे काम कर रहे हैं, तो सोर्स ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन दोनों में अलग अलग है. हाँ, इनसाइडर ट्रेडिंग इज सब पार्ट ऑफ फ्रंट रनिंग, वी कैन से. ठीक है, मान लो कि आपको पता लग जाएगा कि कल टाटा नई गाड़ी लॉन्च करने वाला है, दैट शुड बी अ मार्केट कॉम्पिटिटिव. यो 3 लाख में ऐसी गाड़ी लॉन्च करेगा, दैट विल बी अगेंस्ट द स्विफ्ट डिजायर दैट इज कॉस्टिंग यू द 8 लाख. तो टाटा के शेयर बढ़ना शुरू हो जाएंगे बिकॉज यू नो द इन्फॉर्मेशन फर्स्ट. तो वो उनको पता होती है पहले. ठीक है, तो निपुण, देयर आर टू निपुण, एनीबॉडी कैन टेल अबाउट द निपुण. दो निपुण स्कीम है, ठीक है, देयर आर टू निपुण स्कीम. तो आपको दोनों, क्योंकि इन्होंने क्वेश्चन गलत किया था, सो निपुण इनिशिएटिव फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ द अपस्किलिंग ऑफ द निर्माण वर्कर जो आर वर्किंग इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन सेक्टर. तो हिंदी में कंस्ट्रक्शन को बोलते हैं निर्माण. किसी की हिंदी कमजोर है तो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड कंस्ट्रक्शन इन निर्माण देयर. सो नेशनल इनिशिएटिव फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ upskilling of the Nirman worker. So Nipun. And another is the Nipun Bharat scheme that is launched under the National Education Policy 2021-20. So Nipun is creating a future labor force for the construction industry, which will propel the innovations. Main idea, what is the main idea? To provide the skills to these workers, because in the 2022, this industry is the largest, employment provider industry in the country. Sabse jyada employment is industry ne provide kiya hai country mein. Agriculture ko hum unorganized sector mein include karte hain, but this is we are paying money for that, na? So this is in 2022 provide the 45 million more. Next mein 10 years mein 45 million more workers chahiyenge inke liye. But now in 2022 they are providing the highest employment to the workers there. So in that case, the government is coming up with a scheme for the skill development of these. Skill development. Also in some case they are providing the job in the foreign also. Some of the country are tying up with the Indian government related to the requirement of the worker in those countries. Like in Canada, there's a requirement of drivers. So they will train some of the drivers in the India and also placed in the Canada, in the some of the Gulf country as well. They will do that. So these are the 3-4 components of the scheme. We will look into these components. So the Nipun is an initiative of Ministry of Housing and the Urban Affairs. This is the initiative of Ministry and the Housing and the Urban Affairs. And the idea is to train 1 lakh construction worker for skilling and the upskilling program. So inka major aim hai ki jo construction worker hai, unko kuch skills dena, so they can be work anywhere else. If there is not available in the India, they also go into the foreign. That's a demand of those country in the future. The project is running under the flagship program of the Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Urban Livelihood Mission. Who is Deen Dayal here? Like in Congress, Chacha Nehru, in BJP, Deen Dayal Upadhyay. Okay. Antyodaya last mile tak pahunchne wala. हाँ, अलग अलग है. अंत्योदय सबके साथ लगा रहे थे कि लास्ट माइल सबको कवर करना है अंत्योदय. ठीक है, सो समझ आ गया. चाचा नेहरू फॉर कांग्रेस, दीनदयाल उपाध्याय फॉर बीजेपी. सो इफ यू सी आफ्टर 2014 मोस्ट ऑफ द स्कीम आर कन्वर्टेड इनटू द दीनदयाल उपाध्याय फलाना धिमकाना स्कीम्स. ठीक है, सो द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल इम्पैक्ट. अंडर टाइम पीरियड इज ऑल्सो गिवन देयर, ना, इतने टाइम में हम इतने करेंगे. डिपेंड्स ऑन द एक्टिविटी, ये किस एक्टिविटी के लिए चाहिए. लेकिन अभी एम्स इन्होंने 1 लाख ही रखा कि हम 1 लाख को ट्रेन करेंगे. तो धीरे धीरे दे विल गोइंग इट अप. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, कोई भी जाके अपने आप को रजिस्टर करे. एक्चुअली व्हाट इज द इश्यू विद द स्कीम्स इन द इंडिया, एक मिनट. There is an information gap. Even in the rural area, people don't know this scheme is running by the government of India. There will not be a skill development center in the village. There will not be a skill development center in some of the cities. Those are people will not come from those area. So these schemes run mainly in the urban area, जहाँ पे लोगों को knowledge है कि ऐसा भी हो रहा है, और जिनको उत्सुकता है बाहर जाने की, कि they will come to and attend these workshop and get a certification, go to the outside the country. तो इस केस में सबसे बड़ा इशू है लैक ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. गवर्नमेंट कितना ही प्रोग्राम चला ले, किसी के पास टीवी नहीं होगा तो क्या करेगा. ठीक है, कहीं तो आता होगा, रेडियो पे आता होगा, मोबाइल फोन में आता, कहीं तो आता होगा. इफ यू नो एमएसपी कितने लोग लेते हैं परसेंटेज में, मिनिमम सपोर्ट प्राइस कितने सालों से चला आ रहा है, हाउ मेनी पीपल आर टेकिंग अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द एमएसपी. Only 10 to 12% of the farmers are taking the use of the MSP. So in that case, if you see the schemes are running from the decades, they are taken up by some of the percentage of the farmers only. Farmers ko ye bhi nahi pata hota ki Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sichai Yojana naam se koi scheme bhi chal rahi hai. They don't know about any insurance scheme for the crops. There is a very information gap to the villages. आप तो कैपिटल में बैठे हैं तो सब कुछ पता है, बट इफ यू आर गोइंग टू द रूरल एरिया ऑफ द कंट्री, देयर इज अ वेरी लार्ज इंफॉर्मेशन गैप, तो यहाँ कुछ है वहां कुछ और ही दुनिया इस तरीके से भी है। वहां पे यूपीएससी नहीं पता, वो कहते यूपीएससी एंड देयर इज अ यूपीएससी, देयर इज अ डिफरेंस। हाँ पटवारी एंड दे, आपके पास कोई भी नौकरी है, यू आर ए सरकारी नौकरी एंड यू आर द सीईओ ऑफ द गूगल, सरकारी इज द बेनिफिशियल वन। सो देयर आर डिवाइडेड इनटू द थ्री प्रोजेक्ट्स, सो यू नीड टू राइट डाउन दीज थ्री प्रोजेक्ट्स अंडर दिस स्कीम। नंबर वन, ट्रेनिंग थ्रू रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ प्रायर लर्निंग एट कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट्स। किसी को पहले से ही थोड़ी बहुत इन्फॉर्मेशन है, लाइक समबडी आर कमिंग विद द रीडिंग द एनसीईआरटी द प्रिपरेशन, तो उसको पहली कैटेगरी में रख दिया कि इसको कुछ आता है, तो दे आर इन द फर्स्ट कैटेगरी। देन ट्रेनिंग थ्रू फ्रेश स्किलिंग, कि नया नया कॉलेज से आया है अभी और कॉलेज अटेंड कर रहा है, देयर कम टू द सेकंड वन, जिसको बहुत ज्यादा मेहनत करनी पड़ेगी, जिनको बाहर जाना है, मुझे पढ़ना ही नहीं है, आई विल गो टू कनाडा अंडर द थर्ड वन। सो देयर आर थ्री फेज। वन, दोज हु नो समथिंग देयर, तो दे आर अलग डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम फॉर दोज पर्सन्स। दोज हु आर न्यू टू द सेक्टर्स, लाइक जिनको कोविड में जो पास हो गए उनको किसी ने नौकरी नहीं दी, उनको स्किल्स भी नहीं आते बिकॉज ऑनलाइन ही एग्जाम हो गए, सब कुछ खत्म हो गया। तो इन दैट केस दे आर रनिंग अ डिफरेंट स्कीम, कि आपको कुछ हम स्किल्स सिखाएंगे फ्रॉम स्क्रैच, जहाँ पे आपकी पढ़ाई कहीं यूज नहीं आएगी, तो वी विल गिव यू सम ऑफ द स्कीम्स देयर। एंड द इंटरनेशनल placement through industry builders and contractors. So in that case, those who want to go to some other area, so there is a third schemes, international placement through industry building and the contractors. So these are the three schemes under the Nipun projects. Yes. सब के लिए आप भी जा सकते हैं. Yes, anybody can go. एंट्रेंस एग्जाम होना शुरू हो जाएगा, सबसे ज्यादा भीड़ यहाँ पे होगा ना। ठीक है, नोट्स मिल जाएगा इसका, कुछ लिखवाऊंगा तो वो लिख लेना। मैं निपुण भारत, नाउ अबाउट द एजुकेशन स्कीम, दिस इज द सेकंड स्कीम, दैट इज द निपुण स्कीम, दिस इज द निपुण भारत स्कीम। मुझे यही समझ नहीं आया कि कोई दूसरा नाम नहीं मिलता इनको, कि सिमिलर नेम पे देयर आर थ्री फोर स्कीम्स। Yes, yes. तो कुछ और दे देते, इंग्लिश में नाम रख लो। इट इज लॉन्च बाय द, लिख लो, पांच मिनट और है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन लॉन्च द नेशनल इनिशिएटिव फॉर प्रोफिशिएंसी इन रीडिंग विद अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड न्यूमरेसी। मैथ्स भी आना चाहिए, पढ़ना भी आना चाहिए, सब कुछ है इसमें। दिस इज अंडर द निपुण स्कीम, नेशनल इनिशिएटिव फॉर प्रोफिशिएंसी इन रीडिंग with understanding and numeracy, maths भी आना चाहिए, like Acer survey में सबसे बड़े दो issues क्या हैं, fifth वाला second का नहीं कर पाता है, second वाला first का नहीं कर पाता है, focusing on the दो ही चीजों में test होते हैं, reading में test होता है, maths में test होता है, तो both are included under and derived also from the Acer, Acer की reports के बाद ही they are taking some of the actions, so they are launching a scheme there, Nipun scheme. Ensuring that every child in the country necessarily attain foundational literacy and numeracy by end of grade 3, third class ke baad kuch kuch usko plus minus aa jana chahiye, aisa nahi hogi usko wo bhi nahi aa raha. It was launched in 2021 under the National Education Policy of 2020. So please write the sum of the point about the Nipun, note this scheme, Nipun worker. Who is the implementing agency of Nipun? Kisi ne pucha nahi. मैंने तो बोला ही नहीं इसके इंप्लीमेंटिंग है, मैंने बोला मिनिस्ट्री है बस। इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी नहीं बोला मैंने, नोडल मिनिस्ट्री बोला मैंने। तो देयर इज अ डिफरेंट बिटवीन द नोडल मिनिस्ट्री एंड द इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी। लाइट द इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी, इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी ऑफ निपुण, नेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन NSDC. The implementing agency for the Nipun scheme. फिर लिखा क्यों, बताया क्यों नहीं आपने? नेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन NSDC, नेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन इज द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी ऑफ द नेशनल इनिशिएटिव फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ अपस्किलिंग फॉर निर्माण वर्कर्स निपुण स्कीम्स ऑल्सो राइट. NSDC इज द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्किल डेवलपमेंट. It is a agency under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. NSDC hai, that's under the Ministry of Skill Development. Aisa isliye because they are training the worker for the construction. So construction ka scheme housing ke under skills kon dega unko? Housing Ministry of Skills nahi degi. Skills will be given by NSDC. Also right, NSD will ठीक है हो गया. आज कम लिखवाया है. So we are done with the economy. तीन महीने में it's like 23 topics only. If you go to the magazines, you will find a 30 topic in a month. I selected 23 from 3 months. कितना reduce हुआ आपके लिए. तो इनसे ही if you see some of the topics will be repeating in the future. So we will cover in the like a next round in the Feb end. Okay. So please I will suggest do not go to the multiple sources. Read what we are covering here. If you're getting an extra information बहुत important है तो उसको note down कर लो. Magazines के पीछे मत भागना. Try to make your own notes. That will be the only benefit if you are attending these classes. After attending these classes, if you are running behind the magazines, if you are running behind the notes from the any coaching institutions, so it is the completely waste of the time for you. Please stick to the smaller material. So one of the criteria for cracking this exam, मैंने बताया था, less is more. So there is also the LPG reforms in the UPSC. LPG reform सबसे पहले 1991 में हुए थे. That is for the liberalization, privatization and the globalization. Then in 2015 में हुए उज्ज्वला योजना LPG के लिए. अब 2023 में आप लोगों के लिए less is more. P, personality to handle pressure even during the preparation, even after the selection. इलेक्शन के बाद इससे भी ज्यादा प्रेशर आने वाला है. थर्ड, जेनरोसिटी टू लर्न, याद रखने की हमेशा ही सीखने की इच्छा होनी चाहिए आप लोगों की, उदारता. आई टोल्ड यू सो. तो एलपीजी इज आल्सो प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन दिस प्रिपरेशन एज वेल. तो इसको फॉलो करो, कम से कम पढ़ना है. ऐसा भी नहीं कि लक्ष्मीकांत उठाई कि उसमें 2 चैप्टर पढ़ लिए, कम से कम बोला. तो मीन्स यस यस ओके. नाउ वी विल मीट ऑन थर्सडे फॉर द IR. शबीर सर विल टेक फॉर द IR टॉपिक. देन द लेफ्ट वन इज द साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी ऑन थर्सडे. ऑन थर्सडे इट विल बी द क्लास फॉर द इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन. हो गया कंफर्म 11-12. हाँ.